Watching the News Hour Special Edition.
Welcome back. 24 days after granting bail to Aryan Khan and two others in the Mumbai drug case, the Bombay High Court verdict copy is finally out in the 14-page order. Justice Nitin Sambre has said that there was no prima facie evidence for the offence of conspiracy under the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act. The court said that merely because the accused were travelling on the cruise, it cannot be a ground to invoke the offence of Section 29 against the accused. Even on the WhatsApp chats angle, the High Court has found nothing objectionable. The reasons listed for bail in the verdict dent the NCB's case against Aryan and others severely.
Sir, how do you look at the order now, the Bombay High Court saying that the WhatsApp chat which was recovered by the NCB doesn't suggest that there was any conspiracy being hatched by Aryan Khan or Arbaaz Merchant? How do you look at it?
Well, right from the first day, we said that he has not been found in possession. There is no question of consumption. There is no evidence. There has been no medical test. There has been no evidence recovered against him of any nature. The WhatsApp chats which the NCB relied upon as evidence in their favor, we said that nothing of them connects him to any transaction or any association with anybody, and he has not been in touch with anybody on the cruise ship. So all these factors have been given a consideration by the Honorable High Court. And ultimately, you'll realize that his arrest was also inconsequential and he should not have been arrested at all.
Sir, depending on WhatsApp chats, depending on somebody's phone chats, personal property, how do you look at it? Because time and again, the NCP has depended on phone records and WhatsApp chats. And one more question, are you going to take any legal recourse after the Bombay High Court has given a setback to the NCP?
Well, I don't want to comment on anything on that aspect of the matter, but one thing is for certain, that the Honorable High Court has held that though the WhatsApp messages can be considered by the NCP for the purpose of investigation, it
can. That was Satish Maneshinde, Aryan's lawyer, speaking to Times Now. Let me quickly open this up. Swapnil Kothari, senior lawyer, Kapil Sankla, senior advocate, Ali Kashif Khan, advocate for Munmun Dhamecha, and Avi Singh, advocate practicing in the Supreme Court. Good evening to all of you. Mr. Sankla, let me begin by asking you, what do you make of this 14-page order, sir? This is virtually the court demolishing the arguments of the NCB.
You see, that is one narrative that is being promoted by the defense, and probably rightly so. But you'll have to appreciate one thing, that this order was passed in a bail application when the entire evidence that is to be collected, which probably is before with the investigating officer and has not yet been corroborated or is not good evidence yet, has not been brought before the court. This order is only for the purpose of bail and nothing beyond that. You see, you have to appreciate one thing, that during investigation, the charge sheet, which is the culmination of the entire investigation, which is the entire evidence, documentary, oral, FSL, whatever, is put together in a file which is called a charge sheet that has to be filed within 60 days or 90 days in CRPC and 180 days in the Narcotics Act. And then there is also an extension which is entitled to the investigating officer. So right now to say that nothing has been found, you know, there's a clean chit, no. The clean chit is only for the purpose of bail. The court has said prima facie with the evidence.
Sure. No one is saying that. The reason, I understand that, Mr. Sankla, the reason I asked you that question, because if you see point by point, the NCB, and allow me to read some of this, the NCB had claimed that chats established link to foreign drug bust. The High Court has said nothing objectionable could be noticed. NCB had said that there was presence at the same place shows common intent. The High Court says not a satisfying foundation for conspiracy charge. So, Mr. Ali Kashif Khan,
quickly,
how do you see
this? Let me just answer this in 15 seconds. Tomorrow, if they corroborate the WhatsApp chat with an independent person who says that, yes, I was a drug supplier and I was supplying this to them, Or if they catch somebody and say this consignment was for such and such person, previously also this packet had gone.
Right.
That corroborates.
Right.
So the chain of circumstances at the time of filing of charge sheet will prove whether it's a good case or a bad case. It is too early and too premature right now to say it.
Okay. Ali Kashif Khan.
See, in my opinion, as my learned friend has said, that it would not be right to say whether it's a good case or a bad case at this point of time. Not completely denying to it, but however, it has to be considered that the prima facie which the NCB is trying to put the kind of case ahead. If we peruse the panchnamas of the concern, all these three people, Aryan, Arbaaz and Munmun, if we just go and rely by their own case, if I talk about Munmun Dhamecha's case, when the NCB themselves are saying in their panchnama that a certain kind of drug with alleged amount was seized from the floor, thereafter one other woman was having certain filter pads and rolling papers in her purse, that other woman was not arrested. That other woman till date is not made an accused. But however, Munmun Dhamecha was
right. So you're saying there are discrepancies in the case by the NCB. Okay. Avi Singh, I'm coming to you. But Mr. Kothari, you've been with us on several panels. What do you make of the order copy?
The order is not a very, very satisfactory order, simply because I'll tell you from the view of several cases which are, or several issues that have been left in the lurch. First of all, it has dealt with only two things. One is the conspiracy aspect, saying that, of course, in para 13, it says that we agree with Mr. Anil Singh that there has to be very little evidence at this stage for conspiracy. But nevertheless, the basic information is not sufficient, and so conspiracy aspect is not established, number one. And number two is the confessional statements applying the Tufan Singh judgment of the Supreme Court, obviously, which the Bombay High Court will have to follow, are not sufficient for, they are only merely an aid to investigation. They cannot define an offense as far as this aspect is concerned. Mm. Now, when you look at only these two things, then it's been dealt with very cursorily, as if this is nothing. It's a very simple case. This was a great opportunity for the court to go into aspects of conscious possession, then fundamental rights versus the rigors of Section 37. Then you need to go a little bit into the nuances of what happens when you have very little evidence as far as the conspiracy is concerned. Do you really be dismissive of and apply the bail immediately, or you then try to marry Article 21? So all of these things are very important. So, saying that the WhatsApp chat, okay, and the relevance of the WhatsApp chat at the prima facie stage. So Pranish, this was a great opportunity for the court to lay down parameters for the investigating agency also, and for any accused in the future or anybody trying to venture something into the area of drugs, so as to both know that, there has to be clarity on certain issues. So this is where, the judgment suffers from. If you look at it, it's dealt with very cursorily. Then it says para 17 is very essential, Pranesh. It says, as Mr. Sankla pointed out, that this is at the base. It says that at this stage, it is not relevant. And this is a correct judgment of the court, saying that at this stage, I cannot come to a conclusion, so I have to grant bail. So you have to look at the whole judgment with all these aspects and then come to a conclusion whether
absolutely nobody is calling this a clean sheet in any case. And you added to what Mr. Sankla was saying. But Avi Singh, what do you make of this? Will it be right for us to say that the NCB's case is fizzling?
I wouldn't say that, Pranesh, that it is fizzling. But if they are not able to produce a charge sheet within the stipulated time, say 180 days, then I will have very little faith as far as the investigating agency is concerned, as far as this particular case is concerned, or even any earlier cases where you have to file charge sheets.
Let me get a response from Avi Singh. That was a question for him, Mr. Kothari, but you've answered it pretty much. Let's hear his view now.
Sure. NCB case, so there's nothing to fizzle out. I mean, they had no seizure. They had no reason to even start an investigation in a public space. Some minor quantity of a scheduled drug is recovered from one person. They try and rope in another person. The only reason seems to be who that person's father is. Thereafter, they seize his phone. They don't have a punch number for it. They take the phone. They violate his privacy. They then subject him to all kinds of interrogations. Nothing is found. He should never have been remanded. He should never have been arrested. And the first court should have granted this bail. This has been an entire violation of due process, a misuse of the law. And the only thing I can hope for is I'm The NCB, if they try and produce a charge sheet, they should be not just be slapped on the wrist.
Okay.
The entire process followed by the NCB, there should be an inquiry, and this abuse of process should be brought to book.
Okay, abuse of process.
Be suffering this.
Okay, strong words from Avi Singh. Quick response from you, Mr. Sankla.
Every time we go to the court and we are representing the defense, the first thing we shout is fundamental rights, right to privacy, and that due process of law has not been followed. So these are really great words to use when we are for the defense. But the fact is this, that at this moment, without the charge sheet being placed, everything else is irrelevant. There is no right to privacy of a person who's been accused and arrested. The evidences will be brought, even if those evidences are in his mobile phone or in his person.
Right.
The fact is that the factum of constructive possession was an opportunity that could have been dealt with. And the parameters rightly set. Because at this moment, there is something new that NCB has brought to fore.
Right.
So to say, they are developing the law. So either there could be stop. You cannot read something that the legislature did not intend. Or yes, looking at today, what today is happening,
okay, so let's
what is
see.
Happening right now.
Okay,
to
too premature to really, you know, comment on it. I am completely out of time. Avi Singh, you're raising your hand, but I'm completely out of time. Swapnil Kothari, Kapil Sankla, Asif Ali, Asif Khan, Avi Singh, thanks for joining us on the News Hour Special Edition.